say one thing. I know we had an announcement by Immigration and Customs Enforcement about policies for students, international students, returning this fall. It was somewhat concerning. I think it was a cruel and thoughtless announcement, and we are going to do everything we can do to support our international students. You know, our hearts go out to you in this uncertainty. I just want to say, look for a couple things. One, we're having a webinar next week. I believe it's next Thursday to answer your questions. UC Davis, along with the Office of the President and the whole UC, are exploring various legal remedies. And finally, you know, UC Davis will in fact have in-person classes in the fall. So try to you know, relax and know that we're doing what we can to support you. And just wanted to get that in there. So let's go ahead and get right to your questions. Other than the usual, you know, make the best grade you can type stuff. I think what was pivotal for me was undergraduate research. One thing that I did that got me sort of interested in and ready for what graduate research was like. So I think I would encourage undergraduates interested in graduate school to think about doing some research as an undergraduate. Another thing I think that was helpful was I was involved in student organizations, and that probably is not obvious why that would be helpful. I was an officer, eventually the national chair of National Society of Black Engineers. And that just taught me a lot about, you know, working with people, group dynamics, you know, how to stay organized, how to run meetings. And I found that to be useful, not just in graduate school, but throughout my professional career. How about you?
I would say for me, I had, along the same line as research, I had intense research summer internships. Yeah. And they really added insight into something tangible for the workforce. So when I was in grad school, I could see where it could be utilized. So I would say definitely internship.
It feels like it. My first Zoom call is 7:30 a.m. Usually, you know, I've worked out. I get up about 5:30, quarter to six, and then I work out, and I come back, take a shower, eat breakfast, and then my first Zoom call is at 7:30, and some days my last Zoom call ends right before dinner in the evening. Sometimes I have an evening Zoom call even after dinner. Those are rare. So it does feel like I'm Zooming all the time. You know, the Commodore's song, Zoom, is not my favorite song. You don't Zoom as much as me.
No, we use an application called Slack. I Slack starting about 6:30 a.m. for the rest of the day.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So we compete for bandwidth here at the residence. This is an easy question. The best Star Trek character, in fact, the best fictional character ever created is Spock. No debate. Fight me. Spock is my favorite character of all time for many reasons. I'm pretty much logical and non-emotional like Spock. I just think this whole idea of a person out of with no real connection to his or her environment is just a fascinating topic. So Spock was neither human nor Vulcan, but he had to you know live among the humans and try to function in that environment. I think that's just makes for some fascinating storytelling. Anyway, I won't go into any more depth. I'm sure LeShelle does not have a favorite Star Trek
character. I don't know what a Vulcan is.
Because she often confuses Star Trek and Star Wars.
It's too many spaceships.
Too many spaceships. Well, I don't have reading recommendations yet. What I'm reading right now is a book called The Long Fix. It's a book by Vivian Lee. This was a book that we were asked to read for a retreat that's upcoming for UC Health. It's about how to improve the U.S. healthcare system. So it's pretty good book. I'm about halfway through it, and I'm enjoying it and learning a lot. If you have some recommendations for me of a good sci-fi book, I'd appreciate it. I'm looking for something to read for pleasure. I don't often get to read for pleasure, but I would love to hear your recommendations. How about you?
Well, I think I'm taking on Becoming by Michelle Obama. I'm probably the only woman in America who has not read it.
Good choice.
But to pick that up.
We did watch the special on was it HBO? I can't remember what network had the Becoming special. Right. Those are your questions for this week. Enjoy your summer and go Aggies.
Go Aggies.